John.
Yes, and how are you, Gary?
Oh, fine, fine.
We seem to have a little difficulty getting this line cleared, but I'm happy to talk with you.
Well, happy to talk to you. These lines have to go over all of these hills, and they get tangled up a bit.
I didn't know that those were hills out there.
Well, we call them alternatively.
I thought that there were just some holes in the highway, and so it made it appear that the high spots were hills.
I believe you referred to our state as Virginia.
No, I said West Virginia, please. I've been corrected by Hugh McPherson.
Oh, well, he's a good man to correct people.
Oh, he's been on my, calling me and telling me all the time. Hugh McPherson, he always tells me, he says, now, John, it's West Virginia.
I was just making a tape for him when I happened to turn on the radio. You're coming in loud and clear in West Virginia, so badly, I'm glad to say.
Good, good.
But when I was listening to Dominic, and Augie, very good friends of mine, I could have almost reached up there and punched Dominic in the nose if he didn't know judo. When he was speaking of Ray Palmer,
yes.
Now he and I are both great fans of a book called The Coming of the Saucers.
The Coming of the Saucers?
Yes, by Ray Palmer and Kenneth Arnold.
I don't know about this book.
Well, it's out of print now. It's
out of print, actually, yes.
But I think, now, personally, this is my favorite Flying Saucer book. And as I could gather, they said that Ray Palmer had a piece of the saucer, some fragment from the Maury Island sighting, which he didn't know where it was or anything about it. And I believe that's been misconstrued now because I have the book about that open and I have an analysis of the fragments which the two intelligence officers had with them when they came past.
Mm-hmm.
And I did want to straighten out the point that Ray Palmer did not say that he lost the evidence and didn't know anything about it. Now, the analysis of those fragments which fell from the huge donut shaped object, which is apparently in trouble over Murray Island, I'll read it very briefly. The high constituents were calcium, iron, zinc, and titanium. Middle constituents, aluminum, manganese, copper, magnesium, silicon. Low constituents, nickel, lead, strontium, chromium. Traces of silver, tin, and cadmium. And, here's just one paragraph on this. Nothing of an unusual nature exists in this combination except the unusually high quantity of calcium and titanium. It is interesting to note that titanium, one of the high constituent metals, is now believed to be the key metal in constructing missiles or ships capable of space travel. So this metal was analyzed, John, and it is published in this book. And I wanted to say that
this is the book that was written by Kenneth Arnold and Ray Palmer.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
This tells a very peculiar story, John. You should really, you would enjoy it. Unfortunately, it is out of print. I have one of the remaining copies.
Maybe Ray Palmer has a couple of copies left.
Well, it is going to be serialized in Flying Saucers from Other World, the newsstand magazine.
Yes.
Which, incidentally, I've asked Ray Palmer to send you.
Yes, I received a letter from Ray, but, I think three copies. copies of the magazine, you know, but none of the current copies.
This will be out. It will be serialized. This is out of print. And before I do hang up, you mentioned something else quite interesting to me, the matter of Mr. Otis T. Carr, the fellow who claims to have developed what he calls an electrified flying object, or a flying saucer, or a space which...
Are you talking about OTC?
Yeah.
I didn't even know his name. Otis T. Carr.
Yes, in fact, he's from West Virginia. He grew up in Elkins. He's very familiar with Christburg. Now, John, I just got into this lately. I don't know whether Mr. Carr is a sincere genius or what. His literature, which you have there, looks very impressive.
Mm-hmm. Very, very.
It
costs
like
a lot of money.
Yes, it looks like something that General Motors has put out.
That's right.
Now, I talked to Mr. Carr on the phone, and he has demonstrated the working model, but he has outlined his principle to government people in Washington. They have visited his workshop in Baltimore.